Episode 2085, The Power of Play.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. Guess what today is? I'm going to give you a little hint. It's Friday. Yay! Yes, it is. I'm so excited. You know what? I don't know about this, but as the year has progressed, I feel like my days are getting longer. But I know there's only 24 hours in a day. But you know what? I'm trying to pack it all in. The power of play. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. Well, today is Confessions of an Upset Mama Day. And when I think back growing up, and then I fast forward to today. Oh my goodness. Our children grow up way too fast. I know my mom has said that about us, and now I'm saying it about my children, and now we're about ready to have a grandchild, and I'm sitting here going, I know it's going to fly by. Whether it's a tablet in hand at 6 months or the ACT in sixth grade, a head start seems to be in vogue. What happened to the power of play? I can remember when we would drive to the park to enjoy the day outside. I would gather all the five kiddos. Oh yeah, there were a lot of them. I had to make sure I counted so I didn't leave anybody behind. But we would go and we hit the slides and the swings and the seesaws, and it kept the children active and entertained. It also allowed me to get outside. And yeah, once in a while we would find some friends and they would play along too. And sometimes it wouldn't be that. It was just us as a family. Soon the merry-go-round became the desired attraction. Have you ever done the merry-go-round? It just keeps spinning and spinning and spinning. By the time the children were tired of feeling the centripetal forces, I needed to sit down to slow my spinning head. I'm amazed how fast people will put their kids in the best of the best when it comes to daycare. The traveling team, right? Softball, baseball, soccer, first car, prom dress, or even the best of the best computer to give them what they may or may not have had growing up, but we'll leave out the most natural thing, play. We give everything, absolutely our last penny, but something so basic and so simple, we don't do. We leave it out. When we send our children outside to play, little did most of us realize that we were nurturing the emotional, cognitive, language, and self-regulation skills. That's a lot of great stuff there. And all these skills help to build executive function and social aptitude in children and enhances critical brain structures that support pursuing goals and ignoring distractions. Doesn't that sound like preparation for adulthood? It's amazing what we need, but it's so basic. It's so fundamental. Now, how's that for a little R&D, research and development? Well, in a short few words, play is vital for healthy development. It just is. And I believe we too, as adults, can benefit from play also. We hang out way too much within four walls. And some of us hang out within those four walls and they don't even have windows. That is so sad, number one, and scary all at the same time, that we are becoming an isolated group, yet because of social media, we think we're so connected. It doesn't make sense. If you really want to give your child a head start in personal development, go out and play. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Go out and play. There are so many things you can do out there. And I know because I have been experiencing it myself. Yes, I have been going out and playing. Okay, maybe not digging my hands in the dirt all the time. I did it earlier this season. I planted strawberries, tomatoes. We also worked on our hibiscus and gardenias. Now, those are all of our potted plants that we have. We also have all the other plants that are within our yard that we either have to maintain or we take out. And so I get my hands dirty, but lately it wasn't about getting my hands dirty. It was about just being outside, being present. And I went walking, and not walking for just like 2 minutes, like down to the mailbox or to pick up the garbage can and bring it back up to the house. No, I'm talking for miles. Go out and play. Get some fresh air in your body. Allow yourself to feel it and absorb it. Take your kiddos with you. Take your puppy dog for a walk. If you don't have a puppy dog, go borrow one or get a kitty cat. Put a leash on it and walk your kitty cat. Okay, my cats, I don't think would walk on a leash, but it's a cute picture. But I can't stress enough that unfortunately we have become so sedentary as a society. We're sitting around more. We have more screen time. And all we are is screaming more now because we can't handle ourselves emotionally. Our cognitive functions aren't up to par. They could be better. I mean, come on, let's be honest. We are isolating ourselves. Now, I know some of you are saying, now, Christiane, that's kind of jumping off the far end. No, it's saying that I want us to look at what we're doing every single day in our everyday. Because that's what it's about, being present in your everyday. Are you able to get outside? Now, yesterday, I didn't get outside. You know why? Because it was raining. And no, it didn't have thunder or lightning, so I could have been outside, but I really didn't want to walk around cold and wet. And I thought, starting off the fall season with a slight cold, or sniffles, it wasn't something I wanted to do. Plus, I had two more interviews to do later that week, so I didn't go out. But otherwise, every single day I have been out walking. Did I take my kids out? No. But have I taken them out before? Oh, yes. I drag them with me. I say, hey, come help mom. Come help me do this. And we're outside. And they're older now. When I say older, they're high school and college students now. And I'm still dragging them outside. There's so much we get to appreciate when we go out and play. A few of these things that I just wanted to highlight real quick for you. Communication. When you go out and play, it enhances your communication. Number one, it quiets the noise. We've got so much noise around us. We need to quiet it. And our kids need it too. My husband came home at a reasonable time yesterday, and I was like, oh my goodness, seriously? So I had all four kiddos, the hubby, and me, plus a dog, then three cats. And I'm sitting there going, okay, this is a great afternoon. I'm going to get nothing accomplished, but it's a great afternoon because the family's all home. Well, as I'm sitting just watching and listening, there were four screens on at that time. On top of that, there was also a phone playing music. On top of that, there was a TV that was on. On top of that, someone was cooking in the kitchen. I mean, it was just like noise upon noise. And then we had interruptions from Rhino. Yeah, our English bulldog. He'd be like, hey, pay attention to me. I'm over here. Play with me. It's amazing that when we quiet the noise, how it allows us to think more clearly. We gain clarity and it helps us to communicate better. And if we are with people, if kids are playing with kids, regardless of their ages, they're learning to what? Communicate. That's a skill. All of these are vital skills in growing up and with personal development. We all need them. And can you believe it? We've got now organizations that are paying people to come in to teach what they call soft skills. Not just, oh, wait, do you know how to run this program? No, soft skills, communication. The next one, number two, collaboration. How do you work together to get a project accomplished? If you're building a sandcastle on the beach, how cool is that? Yeah, you can sit here and say, no, I want that. No, I want that. No, I want that. It's mine. But if you begin to work together, the sandcastle can be even bigger and better. Collaboration. Number three, cooperation. Oh, do we need that today? Yeah, we do. We need to have a little bit cooperation so there's a little more what? tolerance with each other. We need to understand that we shouldn't always have to be so selfish, so self-centered. We can be self-aware. We can show self-love and have self-care, but we also have to have cooperation. And so going outside and playing allows that to happen. Think about it when you're playing on a team. It's very important to have cooperation because you have one goal in mind. And you've got to get all of these people to work together. And it doesn't matter the ages, 3, 4, 5 year olds, all the way up to 20, 30, 40 year olds, maybe 50, 60 year olds, right? It's a cooperation. Number four, competition. Competition is healthy. It's good. It allows us to what? Stretch ourselves as individuals. We see something in someone else that we're like, wait a minute, I think I can go for that too. Also, it's healthy because it rallies what? Teamwork. We have to do this together in order to meet this goal so we win the race, whatever it is that you're out to win. Number five, I love this one, compassion. We are lacking in compassion today. And I think if we would take time to really begin to just envelop ourselves in nature, just the fundamental of dirt and sand, even concrete. Yes, if you're in the city, you can still get outside and play. There are a lot of city parks, and I know some of them are closed because of what's going on. I get it. But taking a walk even outside with nothing more than look at what you find along the way. Make it a treasure hunt. I loved it when my kids were little. We would go and I would never call it a scavenger hunt, but we were always doing crazy, funny things. And I'm like, oh, look here. Look what this butterfly is doing. And we would make up a story all of a sudden. We had a book in air, basically. And it was so much fun. And the kids got to really begin to entertain their minds. It stretched their imaginations. And it was all outside. When you begin to do that and you really immerse yourself in it, you develop this compassion for nature, which is a good thing. You develop compassion for each other. We've got to be compassionate towards one another because this cannot be a world of one. It wasn't created that way. If so, God wouldn't have created any of us. We've got to have that compassion. And finally, number six, curiosity. Go out and play. Be curious. Curiosity does what? It expands our knowledge. It allows us to seek more. Last night, my son was sitting on the couch, my youngest, who's in high school, and he was working on a few things, and he had literally three different tablets. So he had two computers out. No, I take that back. One computer, one iPad, and one phone. And I'm sitting here going, oh my gosh, what is the boy doing? Well, there was music going on, so talk about noise. And then he also had something else he was working on with school. And then he had his iPad. And I walked over there to tell him good night. I needed to go take care of some things, more books to read, more interviews to prepare for. And he said, yeah, Mom, I'm going to bed. And I looked what he was doing and he had the skeleton. Now, I didn't really look hard enough. And I thought, I don't think he's taking any sciences that deal with parts of the body and all of this. But I looked and I said, is that for school? Because he was using his pen to write on his screen. I said, are you able to save that? And then, you know, set it in. He goes, oh, Mom, it's not for school. And I said, what? It's not for school? He goes, no. He goes, I'm just learning. And I thought, oh, my goodness. Yes, I know that was inside. But it still is about going out and playing. He was taking his curiosity and expanding it, which then was expanding his knowledge, which was encouraging him what to learn all on his own. I'm like, way to go, Mom. Celebration, right? Now, every day isn't going to always be that way. And you're going to be tired at times. You're like, I don't want to get up and play. I just want to stay inside. I don't want to do anything, but it's important to get out and play. So keep in mind though, that when the child has free play, okay, they can do whatever they want, however they want. It raises awareness to his own interest and preferences. This is when they learn what they like. Trial and error, right? Think about us. Have you gone outside to play a new sport? I know the kids would come home and they're like, hey mom, I'm interested in skateboarding. You want to try? And I'm thinking, okay, give me a soft pad to, you know, land on. Maybe I'll try. I did it for just a minute. I'm like, yeah, I'm done. That's fine. We're good. I don't need that. I'll skate on ice before I skateboard on concrete. I don't know. Some people call it crazy either way, but that's my kind of crazy. So free play really does raise the awareness when it comes to what their interests are, their personal preferences, and you know, it's what they like. And that's important for them to discover. And as they grow, because we had so many, it's hard to have every single child involved in 4 to 5 things. If you have 5 children, they're involved in 4 things. Let's just keep it simple, right? Simple math here. That's 20 different activities going on in a week. Yeah, this mom is crazy, but she's not wacky crazy. I'm just saying, I'm letting it all hang out there. We had to begin as they got older, giving them choices and saying, look, you need to pick 2 because I'm one person and I can't be everywhere. Dad can't be everywhere. And just because your brother and sister are getting older doesn't mean they can be everywhere because they have stuff to tend to. So it's important for them to discover what they like. So then they what? Can make choices and they can weed out what isn't serving them so they can enjoy what really does as they get older. And it plays in part too as adults. We can't do everything as adults. We have responsibilities, but we still have our hobbies, right? We want to be able to be a part of that. So think about that. Keep in mind free play. Now, if play is guided by an adult and the child is managing his actions, he's got control of them, then it's more goal-driven. And you see this a lot in what? Team sports. Exactly. Guided by an adult. And that teaches things too. Also think about it. When we get older, we go and have adult sports teams. And they play together. How awesome. We're always growing. We're always learning. We're always stretching. It's important to realize that we need to start stretching in the area of basics, the fundamentals. And we got to get out and play. The power of play is like art and should be appreciated. So spend some time outside, preferably, or if you can't because of weather. And at times, you know, we're going to be hitting some seasons that the weather's not going to, you know, fare for us in a positive way. So you may have to be creative on the inside, but you can do it. But spend time in your day playing. Go out, train for life. Love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.